They are quick at running away, says Forte. Hmm, too easy, McBain says. I wonder if that boy was okay, says Una. Okay. Ooh, we got new music. Don't talk to the old lady. Thanks a lot! But after all, those desperados stole the spoons that my son's family gave us. Oh my goodness. Well, I assume we can get it back somehow. Since it had a special color text for it. Oh, there's these... guy was hurt. Oh, it's the, not the guy that was hurt by the wooden soldier, though. I thought that's what it was. Hold on one moment. Rena says, thank you for what you did before. I was losing control. I don't blame you, says Una. I'm relieved that my husband's injury wasn't too serious. They say that Daddy's injury is not that serious. I'm glad. Listen, I'll give you my book because you saved my daddy. Forte and his friends receive a Fred Book 6. Sweet. Are you sure it's okay, says Forte? Marine says, yeah, because my mom made a mistake and bought two of the same book. Oh, yeah. Been there. Cool. Next Fred book. Thank you for what you did before, but compared to you, I'm so worthless. I couldn't even protect my family. What are you saying? McBain says. You did a great job. Una says, because you protected your wife and daughter, you got injured, right? You are awesome, says Forte. Maybe I should go learn a martial art, Dino says. I'll kick their butt next time they come. Whoops. Oh, this whole thing goes through. Okay. Oops. You did great. I can't believe you destroyed such huge puppets. I would love to give you a kiss to show my appreciation. Eh? Says Forte. McBain says, really? No thanks, says Una. But she didn't. Carbo says, those spooky puppets moved as if they were like monsters. It didn't seem like the people were moving them, but more like they were moving on their own will. A little tricky to read. Yik! What? The puppets were eerie! They totally made a mess in a tavern. I can't believe it happened to me. Anyway, I wonder who they were. Why did they want to bring those creepy puppets along with them? I thought there was just one. Forte says, really? I'd like to know who they were as well. That's why they call them puppets, because they don't have... I mean, they're machines. I mean, we have machines, right? Primitive machines. Like tillers and stuff like that they have. Grain silos. Oh, yeah. So now I got this sad theme playing. Is there anything else here? It's the old lady's place? Yeah. Ah, this... okay, this is one place we haven't been. That's... I can't go around. That's the guy who got hurt by the wooden soldier. So I want to check in on them. Okay. Restore snuff. Alright, they're very valuable, but four more of them. Even though we restored that game, so we didn't actually lose three of them. This shows you how quickly you can go through them. Warrior sword, blizzard bow. This is all the stuff we have already. But we can sell the warrior armor we have. Since we're not using that. And I'm gonna sell this stupid sword that hurts the wielder. Whoops. Okay. And the warrior armor. That's it. Oh, I sold that. Wait a second. I want to look at it. Surprised he would even buy that. So you can't buy it back? Sword, bow, glove, shield, armor. Yeah, it's gone. Okay. I don't know if I was even using that. Because we have these books, right? And these are not... I guess these are not... books that... Yeah, it's not in here. It's a... It's like an accessory or... Yeah, I guess just having it? Oh, I guess we messed up. I think I never figured out how to use them. This leaves. Lake Wyolina is west, and Cavaro is farther west. Alright, so let's talk to these people. I'm assuming this is someplace I've been, yep. Forte says, ah, you are the... Tori says, thank you for what you did back there. You helped us a lot. Is your brother okay? Asks Una. Well, he's turning pale and sweats a lot, and he seems to have lost consciousness. What should I do? McBain says, let me see. Please, Tori says, please save Jig, my brother. McBain thoroughly examined Jig, who just fainted. Well, how is he? Hmm. His leg is broken. That's why he's breaking out in a nervous sweat. His leg is broken? Okay, let's join the bones. At least his pain will go away a little. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Ha! Ow. Crack. Heh, says Tori. Yeah, says Una. Gah! Says Jig. What did you just do to me? Jig? Says Tori. Are you alright, Jig? Ugh. Do I look like a moth? Huh. It doesn't hurt like before. See? Says McBain. You're awesome, Grandpa. You did it, Grandpa Mac. Thank you very much, says Tori. I merely gave him first aid treatment. His broken bone isn't completely healed. Put a splint on the leg and make sure he stays in bed. Why? I can't go out and play, says Jig. Stay in bed, okay, says Tori. It's good that he's full of energy, Tori says. This is a good opportunity for him to reflect on his past conduct in his bed. I won't let him take even one step outside. That's a good idea, McBain says. Jig, you're grounded for a while. Can I talk to Jig? Yeah. My sister's usually nice, but she turns scary at this kind of time. She's really haggish. Did you say something? Says Tori. Tori smiled at Jig. Nothing. See, I told you. My sister gets scary. Alright, I guess we're done in this town. Oh. Who are these people? What? Says Forte. Young captain says, sorry to startle you. He's got that emo haircut. No, it's okay. I don't care. I have a question. Have you seen a group of people who are carrying strange-looking puppets around here? Just one, actually. McBain says, they just attacked this village. They ran away towards the south. What? They shouldn't have gotten too far yet. Let's go get them. Roger, say the young members. Forte says, wait. What kind of relationship do they have? I'll redeem you for the damage my men caused you, says the young captain. But at this moment, I have to hurry on my way. Are those his men? Excuse me. Are those former militia? McBain says, hmm. What the hell? Alright, let's see if we can ask them. Alright. Ouch! It still hurts when I move it. McBain says, stay calm until the bone sticks together. It's not my day. I wonder what the puppets are about. Maybe a new type of a monster? They are not puppets. Let's talk to everybody again, see if we can get any more info about what these rogues, who they were. She says the same thing. So we probably are meant to get that spoon back. So funny, it's a spoon, but... Nothing new here. I'd like to know who they were as well. Oh, keep forgetting. She does not speak. They went south. So are we supposed to continue on to the lake, or are we supposed to go south as well? I'm not sure. I mean, we're going to run back. How far? Such polite monsters. Well, now they want to fight, huh? I wonder why he changed his mind for a second. Okay, I guess we're gonna continue on to this lake. McBain says, something's wrong. What is it, Grandpa? I'm anxious about those desperados, but I'm also worried about the young captains who are after them. It looks like the desperados have run away towards Polka. There's a risk that they might do bad things in Polka. Let's follow it out. So we are going back. Fuente says, yeah, we would have to go back the other way a little, though. Let's go to Polka. Alright, we're going back again. Only this time we have to do it on our own power. Maybe when we're done, they'll just teleport us back here. To Polka, where they don't play polka. Backtracking. And if you were a lower level than me, you'd have to fight all these monsters to get back, or just run away from them, either one. But if you were a lower level, you should fight them to get higher. Get another screen or two, and then we'll be there. Yeah, this one's always, like, out cold. This might be it. Nope. One more. Forte says, huh? There they are! They are the ones who are robbing in Edel. Wait, something is wrong, says McBain again. Something's always wrong, McBain. Rogue says, Captain Palman. Palman says, we have an arrest warrant issued to you on accounts of desertion, derangement, and suspicion of thief of a wood soldier. If you resist, I won't go easy on you. The rogue says, don't get so irritated. The people in your country don't like you, just like the people in my country don't like us. Palman says, am I the same as you bandits? Oh, okay, I'm sorry. I'll do whatever you want. I'll surrender, so forgive us. Palman says, take them. The boat should be arriving at Polka any minute. You'll be taking the boat to return to the country. That's too much, says the rogue. Robbery is a capital punishment. If you have complaints on my decision, I'll kill you here. Ugh. I understand. I'll get on the boat. Okay, we came back just to see that happen. Forte says, they look like they knew each other, but didn't look like they were good friends. Someone was saying the boat will come, says Una. McBain says, something bugs me. What do you think about returning to Polka? Well, we're almost there. Might as well just continue. Slide not over. A voice says, everyone. Who's back there behind those barrels? It's one of three NPCs. It's either the guy who loves boats, I forget his name, or Breon, or the new guy we met, who I forget who that was. McBain says, huh? Come over here. What's wrong, Mr. Slade? Oh, right, right. The other Slade. The real Slade. Jack Slade. Shh. Don't raise your voice. Those robbers have come to Polka. They want to catch me. Don't worry, says Una. I think they were arrested by different soldiers. Forte says, I believe they have gone to the dock already. The dock, says Slade. Okay, would you do me a favor? Can you peek to see what they are doing? I just have a bad feeling about it. I have a gut reaction as a diplomat. Then why don't you make sure with your own eyes, says Forte. To be honest with you, I am unable to stand up. We have no choice, says McBean. Thanks. You're my savior. He's whistling. Yeah, is he drunk? Una says, didn't he just say that he was unable to stand up? I mean, he is standing up. I'm counting on you. Please don't talk to me. Okay. Should we check in on all these people? See if they know anything? Someone was saying that the boat would come, but did he mean the ferry? Oh, Cyrano. Did you hear about the suspicious people at the port? How rude they are to interrupt my performance. A dubious group of people have come here. I've never seen those people in Marcheros. You guys shouldn't stick your nose into it anymore. It's too dangerous. Anyway, where did that chubby gentleman go? He's right... on the other side of this wall. Remember, there's only three or four buildings in this place. Rico says, I saw people dressing like soldiers, but where did they go? I'm not joking. I really saw them. We don't believe you. They're not going to say anything. They just sell stuff. They just sell stuff. And they sold me a bad sword. House over here. Since the party of Iotam Island was nothing but a failure, the ferry boat should start running soon. I'm glad. It sounds like something happened outside. Where did my child go? Oh, standing there watching. A band of men in cloaks entered through the gate without permission. Do you think I should go warn them? Leave them alone, says McBean. I don't think they will listen anyway. Una goes, ah! Look, there's a ship coming. McPain says, why don't they even sound a bell when the ship arrives? It's not a ferry, is it? Asks Forte. So these guys are... what are they doing? Captain Gazelle says, long time no see, Captain Palman. You look great, Captain Gazelle. Where's his face? I was surprised to hear that you're coming all of a sudden. It's been a long time, Palman, a man's voice says. Who's that? Commander Xenon? Palman says. Xenon says our operation is in the final stage. I myself am going to Cavarro in a day or two. Tell the people of the embassy so. Aye, sir. How's your mission going? We are still searching, but Are you working hard? Even though the soldiers of your unit are not good enough to join the regular force, but they are not coward enough not to be able to find one person? They are not coward enough. They are coward enough to be able to find one person, if you take out the double negative. Search every nook and cranny. Roger, says Palman. What are they looking for? Captain Gazelle says, all those dirty jobs you have to do, huh? Commander Xenon is unreasonable, too. Why is he so mean to you? I have no idea. Well, this duty suits me, so I don't have any complaints. I'll see you later. Let's have a drink after work. The Numeros warship... Oh, is that what it is from Numeros? Quietly left the port of Polka the same as it entered the port, as if avoiding being noticed. Yeah. Let's not notice a warship. I think everyone noticed you already. Palman says, as you heard, Captain Xenon is upset. From here on, you will all separate and collect information on a mysterious singer. Aye, sir. Wow. Phew. I don't feel like going at all. We're standing over here, though. Una says, it's suspicious. Very fishy, says McBean. Bow. Squeak. Extremely dubious, Forte says. Where do you think those soldiers are from? McBean says, in the meantime, let's let Mr. Slade know about this. I'm sure he's waiting in a fret. So the boat has left, right? Oh, I can't go through that. The band of people in cloaks may not be bad people after all. Someone who looked like a leader apologized politely for causing commotions. Who in the world are they? I'm a little bit curious. What do we got up here again? Yeah. Oops. Alright, they don't have anything new to say. Looks like all the soldiers have gone to the dock. But only the soldiers with cloaks came back and spread out to leave. They look cool. By the way, where did that Mr. Diplomat go? Alright. Alright, you can come out of there now. Hey! It's us, says McBean. Oh, it's you, Mr. McBean. Don't scare me like that. You startled us, says Forte. Una says, your attackers have already been taken away by boat to somewhere, Mr. Slade. So, I'm safe. Thank you. And who were they, anyway? That we don't know, says McBean. Let's hear more details from you. Let's hear more details. They must be the Numeros soldiers. The Numeros Empire, says Forte. The mother country of Ambassador Berreger, who is plotting an evil deed with Rish on the Riatam Island. How do you know they are the Numeros, says Una. Slade says, it's because of the guy who is called Commander. There's only one in Weltluna who has that title. He's the Supreme Commander of the Numeros Army, Commander Zenon. Commander? Sounds powerful, says Una. Ruthless and clever. I heard that he cleaned up the ministers one after another who went against Emperor Rousen. Forte asks, why in the world is he here then? I have no clue. Commander Zenon is the number two position following Emperor in Numeros. He must have very important business to take care of. It bothers me, Una says. McBain says it sure does, but we can't do anything about it. Either way, we'll hear it if something happens, since there are units hanging out all over around here. Are the units still hanging out? Slade asks. They should be fine. They didn't look like they would attack randomly. It's funny that they just call them units. Slade says, it started to smell dubious. I'll go home before something bad happens. But I'll have one more bowl. Of course you will. I'd better return to Burrowdane as soon as possible and report it to Prince Duoral. Prince Duoral? Says Forte. He is the ruler of the kingdom of Burrowdane. It was Prince Duoral's skill in diplomacy that prevented us from being invaded, even though we are located right next to military state of the Numeros Empire. Prince Duoral should have more knowledge about the Numeros Empire. I'm sure he knows what Commander Zenon's up to as well. What a disturbing world we live in! The warships of Numeros? Is it in a state of tension around here? Maybe it's a better idea to go back to Graysol. It's not like I'm scared, but, well, a true musician would never yield to a drawn sword. It's just, I'm missing my local dishes, ha ha ha. The Numeros warships, huh? The situation has been taking a dark turn. This means the attackers of Edel were the Numeros, right? Numeros rogues, not soldiers, right? Just curious. I'm mostly wondering if the receptionist has anything different to say. People are talking about much a bigger ship than a ferry boat. Where is it from? If I owned such a big boat, I would go abroad to do business and make a fortune. Sorry, my down thing of the game pad sticks a little. They said that a warship came to the port. That's disturbing. Where is it from? You guys have windows looking out over the port. You can see that. It is from the Numeros Empire. Alright, let's just talk to her one more time and then I guess we're heading back to Edel? Being peaceful is a good thing, but not having any guardsmen could be a problem. Came all the way back here just for that? Alright. What about this kid? The soldiers who were here a while ago seemed to come from Edel. Yeah, they did. Alright. And we're gonna head back there now. And that's not the way. Okay. I would like to leave this place. You can't go that way. You gotta run all the way back.